Hi everybody, hope you all are doing well and stay home, stay safe and protect yourself and your family as well. Thank you for watching my videos and thanks for subscribing. If you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel and encourage me. If you like the video, don't forget to click on the like button and share it with your friends. Today, I want to teach you a topic related to both the state and CBSE 8th class topic, that is synthetic fibers and plastics. In this part of the video, I will teach you about only synthetic fibers and another video will be made for plastics, right? So, what is synthetic? As the name indicates, synthetic and fibers. So before going to directly into synthetic fibers, first of all we have to know what are fibers. What are fibers we have to know. What are fibers? Fibers are the basic units of fabric. The basic units of fabric are nothing but fibers. First, fibers will be made into yarn and then fabric can be made. Basic units of any fabric and based on the origin from where they are produced. Fibers are classified into natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers and synthetic fibers. What do you mean by natural fiber? As the name indicates, they are derived from the natural sources like plants or animals. So natural fibers are again divided into plant fibers and animal fibers. Okay? Synthetic fibers are also called as artificial fibers are man-made fibers. Coming to the examples for plant fibers, cotton and jute are examples for plant fibers. And coming to animal fibers, wool and silk are examples for animal fibers. And what are the examples for synthetic fibers? Rayon, nylon, polyester, acrylic, and spandex. Okay, rayon, nylon, polyester, acrylic and spandex. These plant fibers, cotton and jute, were already studied in 6th class, right? These animal fibers, wool and silk, were studied in 7th class. So in 8th class you have the topic about only synthetic fibers because you have already gone through the natural fibers. What are the benefits or the advantages and what is the composition of the synthetic fiber? We will see now. By the name synthetic, synthetic itself is indicating that they are derived from some chemicals by man. That's why they are called as synthetic or artificial or man-made, because these fibers are derived artificially from the chemicals by human activity. That's why they are called as synthetic fibers. And what is the composition of the synthetic fibers and from where they are usually produced? From where they are usually produced? If you take any synthetic fiber, any synthetic fiber, the arrangement of individual units, the arrangement of individual units, generally synthetic fibers are polymers. Synthetic fibers are polymers. Okay, the individual units are called as monomers. The individual units are called monomers. Mono means single. Mono means single. Mer means unit. Poly means many. Mers means unit. Okay, how can you understand this? Just a bead, black bead necklace you can take, and the beads, individual beads are nothing but monomers, and the entire thread which is arranged with the help of those single units will become a polymeric chain. Synthetic fibers are polymers. They are derived from individual units called monomers. The arrangement of these monomers may be in straight line or may be in the cross-linked pattern. What do you mean by that? The individual monomer units, either they may be arranged like this or they may be arranged like this. Okay, they may be arranged in cross-linked pattern. Both the arrangements are possible. Generally, synthetic fibers are derived from petrochemicals. From where they are derived? Derived from petrochemicals. Okay. Why we opt for synthetic fibers? What are the advantages? Why we prefer synthetic fibers? The first main thing is they are easily available, they are cheap. They are cheap, easily available. We are not dependent on natural sources, so no problem for natural sources. The main advantage is because they are cheap and easily available. Main feature or the main advantage, if you take, some other advantages are also there, but keeping in mind, what are the points you should keep in mind for synthetic fibers? They are cheap and readily available. They are cheap and readily available. That's why we prefer synthetic fibers, because the availability of natural fibers like cotton, wool, silk, all these fibers is limited. Their production is limited. But we can prepare these synthetic fibers with less cost and more effectively. We can produce at a less cost. That is the main advantage of synthetic fiber, why we are opting for that. Right? And their durability is also more. Durability means they will not damage easily. Okay, their durability is also more, and they will dry up easily also. They will dry up easily. If we wash the synthetic fabric cloths, they will be dried up easily. That is also one of the advantages why we are opting for synthetic fibers. So we have seen what are synthetic fibers and what is the composition of synthetic fibers, and these individual units, I said you na, monomers, these monomers will vary from type of synthetic fibers. It will vary from fiber to fiber, but in total it is a polymer. That you need to remember. Whenever the term synthetic fiber comes, you should be aware that it is a polymer consisting of monomeric units. Okay, mono, single, mer, unit, poly, many, mer, unit. The arrangement of monomers may be in a straight chain or may be in the form of cross-linked chain. These are all about synthetic fibers, advantages and some of the features. Then going to individual fibers, right? Individual synthetic fibers we will see. First one is rayon. It is not completely synthetic fiber. It is a semi-synthetic fiber. It is semi-synthetic because it is derived from cellulose, cellulosic fiber, and it is also called as artificial silk because it resembles silk. Because silk is costly, there is need to invent any other fabric which resembles the property of silk. Then rayon was invented at that time. So it is artificial silk. It is derived from cellulose. Because it is derived from a natural source, cellulose, it is called as semi-synthetic fiber. If rayon mixed with cotton, it is used in the preparation of bed linen, bed sheets. Rayon mixed with wool in the manufacturing of carpets. Okay, and rayon, as it is semi-synthetic, it can absorb some moisture from our body. Whenever we sweat, it has the ability to absorb sweat to some extent. When compared to other synthetic fibers, it can absorb moisture. It is one of the advantages of rayon. And when compared to natural silk, obviously it is less in cost. This is about some of the important points related to rayon. Coming to nylon. The name nylon derived from two places, New York and London. At a time it has been prepared in both in New York and London. That's why the name nylon came. It is the first synthetic fiber, we can say. First synthetic fiber. It is derived from petrochemicals. It is very hard and it is having high tensile strength. What do you mean by tensile strength? It can resist pressure or load without breaking. It can resist heavy loads without breaking. And it is also highly elastic. It can regain its shape. It regains its shape even after stretching a bit. That is the main features of nylon. What are the main features of nylon? It is a synthetic fiber. It is having high tensile strength and elastic. If we mix nylon with some of the natural fibers, we can use it for different manufacturing of different products. And as it is having high tensile strength and elastic, it is also used in making parachutes, trekking ropes and fishing nets. Okay, they can be mixed with, this nylon can be mixed with any other type of natural fiber, and they can be made into blended fabrics. Okay, this is about main points I am discussing. Some other points will also be there, but main points coming to nylon I am discussing. The next synthetic fiber is polyester. As the name indicates, poly, it is a polymer. What are the units, monomer units here? Polyester. Ester are the monomer units here. These are also derived from petrochemicals. The PET bottles come under this polyester, polyethylene terephthalate. PET polyethylene terephthalate will come under polyester. Polyester can be mixed with cotton, polycot, polywool, polysilk. Actually, the most famous varieties of polyester are terlin, terricot, terrywool, terrysilk. These are the blended fabrics made out of polyester. Polyester, as the name indicates, it is a polymer of ester units. Okay, the main varieties in this polyethylene terephthalate, which is used in the manufacturing of bottles, and polycot, polywool, polysilk, these are the blended fabrics. As that of remaining synthetic fibers, it is also having some features like hydrophobic. It repels the moisture. Polyester will repel the moisture. It will dry up easily. It is having high tensile strength when compared to natural fibers. Durability is more. But one of the disadvantages of all these synthetic fibers is they will melt before they burn. So what will happen if any fire accident happened? That will be stick to the surface of the skin, causing severe injuries. That's why it is not advised to use polyester or synthetic fabric cloths near the area where fire is there, like in laboratories or in the kitchen. What is the feature that is not favoring? Here? Because it will melt before it burns. That is the disadvantage of all synthetic fibers in common. In addition, they are derived from petrochemicals, so they readily catches fire. These are the some of the points related to these synthetic fibers, and we have covered up to polyester. Then two more synthetic fibers are there: acrylic. It can be called as fake fur, artificial wool, okay, because it is an alternative, developed as an alternative of wool. Because wool is costly, so we have to think about another source where the features of wool is there, but at the same time it is less costly. And some of the other advantages of acrylic is if they are not affected by moths or insects. But natural fiber wool will be affected. Okay, but this acrylic will readily catches fire. Because all these derived from petrochemicals, it is catching fire easily. When compared to others, acrylic and polyester will catch fire readily. As they catches fire readily and they will not burn because they melt, they will stick to the surface of the skin, causing severe injuries. And the last synthetic fiber we are going to see is spandex. Spandex is also called as lycra. Spandex is also called as lycra. And the features of this spandex is similar to that of rubber. Similar to that of rubber. And it is highly elastic. Highly elastic. That means we can stretch one length of fiber to about 5 times. If we consider one length as 100%, we can stretch the fiber up to 500%. So it is advisable for swimsuits, sportswear, athletic wear, and in case of undergarments. It is a fabric used for making sportswear, athletic wear, that is nothing but same only, and undergarments and swimsuits also, because it can expand up to 500%. If we consider one length as 100%, it can extend up to 500%. That is why it can be used during swimming as a swimsuit, right? These are the few things related to the synthetic fibers. As we have already seen some of the advantages, coming to disadvantages, because they are hydrophobic, this hydrophobic nature itself is a disadvantage, because it will not absorb moisture and it will cause some discomfort to humans when they wear that for longer time. And one more thing, they develop a charge, and those synthetic fabric cloths will be attached to the skin and cause some irritation. Okay, and as they readily catches fire, it is also disadvantage only, and they will cause severe injuries. And we can say is a little point as a disadvantage also, as these are petrochemicals. They contain some toxic chemicals during their manufacturing, which may cause cancer. They may be carcinogenic in some cases. Apart from that, they are responsible for microplastic pollution, because all synthetic fibers are considered as microplastics. And if we wash the cloths, whenever the fibers come out, they are going along with the water we are using. So they will be deposited somewhere as waste, because they will not degrade. Synthetic fibers are derived from petrochemicals. They are not biodegradable. So what will happen? They will be deposited as it is. So it will cause harm to environment. One of the pollutants, you can say. Synthetic fibers are microplastics, are one of the reason behind the plastic pollution. These are considered as microplastics. So that's all for today. I think you have enjoyed learning, and thanks for listening to my class. If you like the video, please click on the like button, and if you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends and relatives, and encourage me. If you want any specific topic, and let me know that in the comment box, then I will try to upload the topic. And that's all for today. Hope you have enjoyed. Goodbye. Bye-bye.